Please state your name for the folks at home.
Rebecca.
Rebecca. Rebecca what?
Tucker.
Rebecca Tucker. So, Rebecca Tucker, do you work here at CBS?
I do.
What do you do?
I work for you.
Oh, really? What do you do?
You're the...
I'm the president of your...
Production company. Good girl. That's right. Now, Rebecca, sounds to me like one of them highfalutin Hollywood titles. Is that correct, Rebecca?
It's better than my old title.
Exactly. What was your old title?
Assistant to Craig Ferguson.
Assistant to Craig Ferguson. But Rebecca, you did such a great job that you became the president of the company. You're like that guy that did that thing with the hair club for men.
I know.
You really hate being on TV, don't you?
Yeah, I've avoided it for 4 years.
Yeah.
So, thanks.
What Rebecca doesn't know is that I am now scared of what she'll do to me during the next half. See this simpering, kind of frightened girl? That's not who she is.
I know all your secrets.
She knows all my secrets. I don't have many. What are my secrets? I'm a flatulent old man. That's not much of a secret.
That's true.
Hey, what do you mean, that's true? Here's what happened. This is the last show in this studio. I'm going to tell you a story of what happened once, when about maybe a couple of months ago. This is my memory of this studio I'll take away. Rebecca came into my dressing room one day and said, "It smells like farts in here."
It did. It was bad.
And I was the only one in the room. And then, how did we get rid of it?
You took a tub of baby powder and tried to sprinkle it into the air to absorb the smell. It didn't work.
Didn't work. No. Smelled like a farty baby. Still, it worked out in the end. You became head of the company.
Yeah.
It's not a very big company.
No, it's just me.
Just you, yeah.
Thanks.
Well, there you go. Good times. No. No, you ain't the boss until the commercials come on. I'm holding as long as I can. We'll be right back.
Ferguson, sponsored by Advil. Make the switch to Advil now. Ladies and gentlemen, Craig Ferguson.
Applause must die away quite naturally. Jerks. I am very excited tonight. How can you tell? This is how you can tell. Craig, you've got tiny little erections on your nipples. Yes, I do. And not just on my nipples. Oh, it's a great day for America, everybody. Yes. It is. It's a very... Now, it is It's a very emotional day here for the staff at the show. And by staff, I mean me. And by emotional, I mean, because we've been at this the studio here. When I say studio, you know. This is stage 58 of CBS Television City. I've been here 7.5 years. Tonight's our last night here. Last night. And then, don't get excited. We haven't been cancelled. We're finally moving to another studio. We're moving on up. And you know when you're about to leave something and you realize how much you're going to miss it? Well, that's kind of the opposite of what's going on here. 7 years of me complaining about what a dump this place is. Finally, somebody at CBS heard me. And today they sent me a little note. It said, looking forward to the next chapter in our relationship. Kind of bothered me, though, because they wrote my name over Katie Couric's. Oh, yeah, I did it. That was my fault. And we're not moving far. The new studio is literally down the hall. It's not ready yet, but it's where they used to tape the Pat Sajak show. That's why it's taking so long to get it ready. They're trying to scrub out that Sajak smell. He smells like vowels. I have a lot of fond memories here, though. There was the time the power went out, and then the time the roof leaked, and then the other time the power went out again. But now we're moving down the hall where it has the exact same electrical system and the exact same roof. We'll be living the dream. Now, if you tune into this show over the next couple of weeks, you will still see me in this studio. And CBS would like me to inform you that these are not reruns. It's just I'm having some recent guests come back so we can talk about the exact same stuff we talked about last time. On an all-new, unless you've seen it, Craig Ferguson. In case you're wondering, I am taking Jeff Peterson with me. He's coming with us to the new studio, aren't you, Jeff?
Boy, that was a really exciting...
Yeah, yeah, no,
thank you.
You know what? You know what? You know what? Too little, too late, you bastard. Right, Jeff?
Kiss my ass.
Yeah, kiss his bony plastic ass. Right, Jeff?
Yeah.
Yeah. It is plastic, isn't it?
It is.
Like I didn't know. That's right, I kissed my own skeleton's ass. I considered replacing Jeff with the gay robot from Star Wars, but he said no. Do we have a picture of the gay robot from Star Wars? There he is. I'm gonna get some angry letters now. How dare you? How dare you, sir? We're also gonna be bringing the picture of Paul McCartney. We got the picture of Paul McCartney? Yep, we are. Pack them all up. We're going to take them all over. Because the new studio will be the same old crap. People have said, oh, what's the new set going to be like? It's going to be like this. It's the same set. It's the same set. I know what you're thinking. They don't do that in TV. That's right. They don't. We're taking this set and adding a bit onto it. I'm not kidding. This set, adding a little bit onto it, a little bit more of a window so you can see more of the city of Los Angeles. And that's it. Now, people have been saying to me, I don't want the show to change. And I'm like, who are you? Everyone else does. Anyway, frankly, I don't know what's wrong with change. People in the audience during the commercial breaks are always going, spare change, spare change. This mob especially, I think, don't you think?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah. Last night, an old 58, and what have we got? Mean people. I wonder if the new studio means we'll get fewer hobos. Do you think we'll get less hobos in the new place? Now, if you're a regular viewer of this show, I'm sorry. But you know, I come out here every night, I stand in this spot, and I talk about stuff on my mind. I've done 1,565 opening monologues, 4 jokes, and... spread out through that time. We have had some amazing moments out here. We'd like to take, if you'll indulge us, a nostalgic look back at some of the greatest moments from Stage 58. Play the clip, Michael. remember the first night I walked onto the stage, I had no idea what I was doing. I still don't, but the difference is back then, I gave a rat's ass. Our new studio will have all the usual talk show stuff. You know, we'll have the desk, the chairs, the podium, the audience pleasure dungeon, the glory holes, the glass unicorns, the sex swings, the ferrets, the monkeys, the handcuffs, the bedazzlers, the hookers, the mimes, and Fred Willard. You know, so... All the classic talk show stuff. Yeah, all the stuff you need for a good old creepy show in a basement. You know, the one thing that's exciting, we're going to have a bigger audience. It won't really make a difference. It'll just be more people not laughing. But there's just... But the new studio is going to be super high tech. We'll have these new fancy gadgets. They have all the TV shows now. They're called lights. And Lesbian Row will be much bigger. Yes. Now, wait, no, perhaps you misunderstand me. I don't mean we're getting more seats. We're just getting bigger lesbians. I'm very excited. We're going to have the portliest lesbians in show business. And right now, of course, this studio is directly above The Price is Right, which is below here. We're in the basement, they're in the sub-basement. And then, but so the new studio up there is directly above The Young and the Restless. Oh, too late, too late! Stop trying to be my friend now. There'll be The Young and the Restless down there and The Old and the Irritable up here. See, I've no idea what CBS plans to do with this space when I'm gone. I always thought this room here would make a great meth lab. Or they could use it to store Drew Carey's old back fat. Wait. You oohed me? That was supportive. I said old back fat. Old back fat. He doesn't have any more. I'm being supportive. They could just roll his back fat in and park it where the desk is now. Drew Carey's old back fat would be better at hosting this show than I am. And I've embarrassed a lot of interns on this show, you know, on stage 58 for a long time. But they get a college credit, and I enjoy a laugh, and everybody wins. So tonight's the last time I can do it from this stage. Let's have a round of applause for the interns. Everybody, let's bring in interns. And come on out, interns. Get off. Holy crap, my eyes are burning. You all right, Jeff?
It smells like Sajak. Tonight's program is brought to you by Pat Sajak's Air Freshener. Vowel odors on the attack? Stop them with the sweet smell of Sajak.
Show in the old studio before we move to the new studio, and you'll be hard pressed to tell the difference. Right, Jeff?
That's right.
Let's do the thing where we talk like robots through our organs. Yeah. All right, you ready?
I can't wait to move to the new studio. Oh, it's going to be so exciting. It smells like farts in here. You smell like a farty baby.
Farty baby would be a good name for a song, wouldn't it? Farty baby! Farty baby!
What's that smell?
What's the smell?
Farty baby!
Farty baby! Come in the club! When we do Here Come the Players.
Yeah.
Let's do it.
Yeah.
Here Come the Players. What time is it, Jeffrey Peterson?
It's street mail time. Time to take advice from a man who smells like a farty baby.
That's a good smell. A lot of women like that smell.
Love that smell.
Let's do our own jingle. You ready?
Sure, yeah.
Tweet mail time. What? Who's that at the door? What's going on? Show. I'm trying to do the emails, Chris. You're interrupting with your friendly horse thing.
I know. I wanted to come by on the last night of the old studio. Yeah. It's nice that you're moving to a bigger house, though.
Yeah,
right?
Well, I needed that. You know, when the last kid came along, and things were just too small.
You need more room for farts.
More room for farts? No, it wasn't that. It was just Rebecca said that. It was something that happened. It was something to do with the machinery.
By the way, it's my mom's birthday. I just wanted to say happy birthday to my mom, Sharon. Today is her birthday.
Happy birthday, Sharon.
Yeah.
Hey, let's sing her a birthday song, one that's copyrighted.
Right, I got it, yeah.
All right, okay, ready?
Yeah.
Happy birthday, Sharon.
Happy birthday. Hope your birthday doesn't smell like baby farts.
Chris, I'm just doing some emails, so perhaps you could help me out.
I would love to.
All right, then. This is from Jacob in Portsmouth, New Hampshire. Yeah, you ever been there?
Yes, no. It sounds like a place.
Oh, it's great. Jeff, you ever been to Portsmouth?
Oh, Jacob or New Hampshire?
Either one.
Yeah, both.
Yeah, all right. Now, I don't know if you could tell, he's got a picture of flamingo there. This is a problem for Jeff and I, because we don't like flamingos.
What is wrong with them?
What, Jeff? Tell
him. Foul animal.
Your flamingo, Chris, when he's hot, mm-hmm. will pee on his own legs to keep cool, like a Kardashian. That is a foul animal, is it not?
I did love that flamingo sex tape with that rapper. I thought it was really fantastic. That is how flamingos got famous.
That's true. They weren't famous before that. That's the extent of their... Anyway. Jacob says, dear Craig and Chris and whoever else is around, Jeff, Rebecca, are you going to miss the view out the window when you leave for the new studio? Oh, no, it's right next door. The view will be much the same.
Yeah, much the same.
We're just being over there, but we might miss some of this end of the large...
Do we get to break something? Why?
Everybody keeps saying that.
No.
All of this stuff.
I could throw this through there.
Don't throw anything through anything. All of this is going to the new studio.
No,
don't. Don't even lean things over like that.
I'm sorry.
This is all we have.
Okay, sorry.
Except with some extra bits in the new place. And an exciting reveal.
What? What is it now? Spoiler!
Nah, it's not a real thing.
Damn it. All right.
This is from Brenda in Fall River. You ever been there?
Sure. Yeah, lovely place.
Yeah, Fall River, Massachusetts, beautiful.
Lovely thing.
Yeah, I go there. You know what I enjoy there? Fly fishing.
Fly fishing.
Yeah, I heard you
great.
Like fly fishing. You
it's
like fly fishing.
I love fishing for flies. Uh-huh. Is that what you're talking about?
Hi, Craig and Jeff and Chris. Is there a lot of junk stored behind your desk that you're getting rid of now? If so, can I get something, please?
What do you got back there? Come on, what do you got back there?
Stuff. Hold on.
What is that? I think I see it. Oh, there's a whole box of stuff back there.
There is, actually.
I don't know what that is. What is this?
Stuff. We got all the puppets from... That was... Flag of Canada. Him. Char.
Oh, Jeff!
Oh.
Doctor needs to have an examination.
Yeah. Oh, this was a great one. This was like a mask of me.
Oh.
Oh, man, we got a lot of stuff here. I think I'll take all this, though. Hey, do you want a free T-shirt?
Do I? Yes, of course I do.
All right, it's from the Crazy Horse Striptease Saloon in Adelaide.
Oh, another one?
Yeah. Oh, man, there's a lot of stuff in here.
What is that?
This is my pen I used to write to celebrities with.
This is a very offensive shirt. Can you see that? Well, on the front, getting better and wetter. Come on. Why would you wear that?
You know what this is? This is a space age didgeridoo.
Is it really?
Yeah.
It looks like I would have said astronaut bong.
This is on TV right now.
Didgeridoo.
No. All right, so that, yeah, I hope that helped.
Well, we never answered that part.
I can't remember. This is from David in Mesa, Arizona. You like Arizona?
It's a lovely place. I do like Arizona.
Yeah, no,
it's not in the summer, though. You want to tear your eyes out. It's so damn hot there. But if you go in the winter, it's like normal weather everywhere else.
Do you understand his accent? I don't get any of that.
No clue. No idea.
I don't understand a damn word he said there. You American?
I'm American, son.
I don't
American! Don't. Apostrophe American! M-U-R-R-C-A-K-A-N.
Hey there, everybody. I've been dating my girlfriend for about 5 years now, and she's expecting me to propose. How much longer do you think I can avoid it? Oh, man, you're too...
Well, I'd say forever now that that's been read on television.
Yeah. Yeah, he's right. You'll die alone!
Sandy the Shark says, never trash your loved one on national television. How am I breathing out of water, Ted?
Hey, give me that, give me that.
Keep that, fine. I'm keeping this.
Yeah.
Oh, well, you can't get this one.
Don't hurt me, cartoon.
Seriously. Nice. Oh, damn it. I feel so powerless without my big flappy hand.
You can use your other hand. That sounded dirty.
That could mean anything.
It could mean anything.
That could mean anything.
All right, this is from Carrie in Flint, Michigan. I don't know if you can tell from the foreground, but Carrie's a cockatoo.
She loves this.
Maybe she just likes cockatoos. Maybe that's what it is.
That could be a... Yeah.
Dear Craig and Jeff, is Morgan Freeman... is Morgan Freeman moving with you to the big new studio? Jeff.
Yes, I am.
Yeah. This is amazing. I want you to read this one out, Chris.
All right.
Amazing.
Okay. It's from Detroit, Michigan. Did I do that right?
Yeah.
All right.
Who's it from?
That's from Jackie. From Detroit, Michigan. Dear Craig, can you make this the last email you read ever in your old studio? You totally screwed her. Because you got it on the air.
Stinker! We'll be right back. Chris Hardwick, in the new studio, they'll have to march further. It's gonna be so great. My first guest tonight stars in Political Animals. Political Animals. She's in a show. And let me tell you, this show called Political Animals. Sunday nights on the USA Network. Take a look at this. The lovely Carla Gugino, everybody. Carla Gugino. Hey, Carla.
Hello.
You look okay. You look great. I mean, great.
Thanks.
Really good. I really like your dress.
I really appreciate it.
Do you mind if I just touch a part of it? You can...
Look, right here. That's right, yours, okay. Right there.
It's stretchy.
It's stretchy.
And it's stretched in some places, and in other areas it's relaxing.
It's true. Well put.
Yeah, no, it's... well put yourself. You look very, very well.
Now, and look, my shoes and your tie match.
That's a sign.
I think so. I'm not sure of what, but something.
Oh, you know what. I like your shoes. They're golden shoes.
They are.
Did you win them from a fairy?
No, but I just felt like it was the last night in your studio, and I needed to do something special.
Well, I have to say, it's great that you're here, because you always light up the place with a, you know,
Thanks, I think.
So you always light up the place with your... Apparently, I have turned into Sling Blade for the last show in this.
You always light up the place with your...
Political animals was tough to say, too.
Well, it was. It was hard to say political animals. Yeah. You may want to change the name of that show. I was in that show.
I know. That's what I was going to say.
Yeah.
I've always wanted to act together. I mean, we get to do this, which is amazing.
I'm not acting. I mean everything I say to you right now. That's right.
But we were in the same show, but we didn't get to act together, which was disappointing to me.
Well,
though you were great in your part and everything, but...
Well, I played me on this show talking about...
I know.
I
know.
Wasn't that big a stretch?
It was really good, though.
If you had to play a hot girl, oh, no, that's going to really be hard for you. Now, who do you play in this show?
I play a journalist, a Washington journalist.
Well, right there, that's a stretch, because I've met Washington journalists, and they're hideous.
Well, you know, she's a smart cookie. She's definitely, her moral compass is a little questionable.
Well, that's Washington.
And that's easy for me to play, you know, so.
Really? Really, you have a dodgy moral compass?
No, I have.
What is your kryptonite? What is the thing that throws your moral compass off?
That's
cheesy snacks.
Chocolate. Speaking of which, I brought you cookies. I brought you cookies that are upstairs waiting. Fresh baked cookies for your last studio. Yeah, right. I'm Italian. I couldn't help it. I felt like
it's actual cookies we're talking about. It's not code or anything.
No.
No, I brought you cookies.
No, they're just plain old delicious cookies.
Well, that's great. Because if there's something I really am looking forward to, it's more.
I don't know. We started going down the moral compass road. And I just felt like
it made
me a little nervous.
Do you do a lot of baking? Did you bake these cookies?
I did not bake these cookies. I can bake a really good cookie, but I didn't bake these cookies.
Do you get baked a lot? Do you do a lot of marijuana?
Going straight for all the
No.
I was raised in Northern California, so there was a period in my young life where I was more inclined that way. Not anymore. No.
Did you go to San Francisco a lot when you were there? That's northern-ish.
It is northern-ish. Yeah, I lived in Big Sur. I lived in Paradise, California.
It's lovely up there, Big Sur.
It
looks like Scotland, but
it does.
It does really does. It's like Scotland, except that people have all got big shiny teeth.
Yeah, that's true.
That's how you know the difference. Like, I'm in Scotland. No, you're not.
Kieran Hines and I were talking. Kieran Hines is amazing in political
animals. Kieran Hines, the Irish actor?
Yeah.
He's fantastic. Did you ever see him play Julius Caesar in the HBO thing?
No, Rome? I did not see Rome, but I've seen him on stage a couple times, and he is extraordinary.
He's crazy, this guy.
He is.
I mean, he's like, wow.
Yeah.
Yeah, I wouldn't have him out here.
Well, he plays the ex-president in this, and he was like, I have Irish teeth more than American teeth. And we were having a whole teeth discussion.
You do?
No, he does.
Oh, he does. Yes. I was going to say, your teeth are lovely.
No, I am part Irish, but my teeth are more...
Your teeth are Northern California.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
Well, you know, it's a different type of character you would be asked to play.
Yes.
You know, if your teeth weren't nice,
Craggy.
It'd be like, you know, they'd ask you to play Lady by the Guillotine or something like that. You don't want to play Lady by the Guillotine. No.
I mean, I want to, you know...
You want to wear the gold shoes and the green dress and go, And you should. You're beautiful.
I would get some craggly teeth for something, but not Lady by the Guillotine. Something more
interesting. We used to do some sketches and I played Prince Charles. I got some teeth.
Yeah. It makes you talk totally different, Tim.
Yes, I talk like that. All the time.
Yes.
I just suddenly started talking like this. Amazing.
Well, there you are. That's nice. What else have you been up to apart from the political animals then?
I was stuck in a hailstorm just last week in New York. Who knew that in 97 degree weather it hails?
Oh no, yeah, that's yeah, well, it's
that. The, I it was
all
the cold thing.
No, it's the Mayan apocalypse.
Oh well, yeah. The world is ending.
Yeah.
Yes, that is why. I don't think that's true though. Well, no. No, because also 2012 wasn't 2012 in their calendar.
Right. That's also, the Mayans themselves, the Mayan cultural heritage people have said, we didn't say this. Why are you saying
exactly.
we say this?
Because
and they're
people
like, shut
want
up, Mayans, we know better than you.
People want something to be afraid of, you know, right, makes life exciting.
Well, what are you afraid of then? Bananas?
No, I have no fear of bananas. Actually.
Any fruit or vegetables frighten you?
No. I'm pretty good with my fruits and vegetables. Yeah,
right. What does frighten you then? Spiders?
Spiders don't frighten me that much. Cockroaches. I don't like cockroaches. They move really fast, and they're very sort of like you don't know where. Yeah, I'm not a fan of cockroaches.
Jockeys are the same.
they do move really
fast. They move very fast, and you don't know what way they're going to go.
I never thought of that.
Yeah, jockey, you got to be careful.
Yeah, yeah.
If I'm in a room and there's a jockey and a cockroach in that room, I'm like, So there, did you go on vacation this year yet?
I did go on vacation, as a matter of fact. I went to a very fancy place, St. Bart, where I'd never been.
Oh, yes, that's in the Caribbean. I've never been there.
Well, someone did warn me, though, nor had I, and they were like, it is going to be the scariest landing of your entire life. And I'm not afraid of flying at all. I've been flying since I was a kid, and I was like, oh, I'll be fine. Cut to the scariest landing of my entire
really?
Life.
Really?
Literally, it's like we scaled the highway. I'm not kidding. Went straight up, and then you nosedive.
That's like I'm flying
the
plane.
And then you end at the water, and you're lucky if you don't go into the water. And I said, has anyone gone to the water? Oh, they were like, oh, yeah, of course. Many planes have gone into the water. So basically,
why didn't you go somewhere else? Go to Vegas or something. The Vegas airport's huge.
I didn't know.
You can see from miles away.
I didn't know. I can't believe so many people go there, and no one had told me that before.
Well, did you have a nice time when you were there, though?
I did. It ended up being worth it. The first day, it was sort of shell shock, like, this better be worth it. For what? Just like, I just risked my life.
Yeah. Did you get a bra made out of coconut shell?
No.
What, you
Why
got
didn't
it?
I do that?
You should do
I
that. You're a sexy woman. This is the time in your life when you get
where
to
I
do
should
it.
Get a bra made out of coconut shell.
Bra made out of coconut shell. Coconut shells and a piece of string and, you know,
and
enjoy
then
you're it.
You
use it while you got it, baby.
I'm going to think about that my next time.
Oh, I think about it all the time. When you walked out there, I was thinking, coconut shell bra. We have to take a break.
Oh, this is painful. I don't want to take a break. Must we?
Well, we don't have to. We keep talking, but CBS get all tweaked
all right,
out about
all
commercials
all right.
and stuff.
Okay.
Welcome back, everybody. I've never met this woman before in my life.
I just showed up.
Yep.
I snuck in.
In a coconut bra, no less. So, listen, you were saying you've all but moved to New York. Then.
Yeah.
You're there a lot of the time.
Yeah, which has really been kind of crazy. I thought, I have never, since I was 14, I've always had a home in L.A. And I've always gone back and forth and traveled. But this is the first time I'm officially a New Yorker. So I'm like visiting L.A. to see you.
That's nice.
Mm-hmm.
Do you enjoy the smell of the pee-pee there?
There are a lot of smells there. Well, you do have to get used to that.
It's a rich, aromatic feast.
It really
feast,
is.
Isn't
it really is.
I mean,
especially in the
summer.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, it gets a little bit, whoa!
Oh, yeah. No, it's definitely, you know.
Now, you know that all smell is particular, right?
What?
Well, all smell is particular, which means each smell that you smell, if
right.
you smell anything, for example, if you smelled something unpleasant,
right.
that means there are molecules of that, whatever substance is, are going in your nose. That's how it's detected.
That is disgusting.
Yeah.
That is information I so don't want to have.
Well, you know, you got it now. You can't unthink it.
You're right. Exactly.
Yeah.
So every time I smell some nasty smell, I'm going to think about what you just told me.
It's going inside your nose. Yeah. And
it's not right.
And forming its own little...
Oh, God.
Like, so when you smell like something...
I have
like,
a small nose. Maybe that's good. Maybe not much can get in.
Oh, enough.
True that. Well put.
Oh, true that. Yeah, yeah, true that. Word. You're absolutely right. Yeah. Is that what we're doing? True that? Yeah, okay. Fine. That's about all I got, though.
Me too, yeah. That's sort of, it's hard to go on from there.
Yeah, I like your, I guess we should call it bling. here.
The little bracelet?
Yeah, it's nice.
Yeah, I like it too.
It's like little balls on your wrist.
There's a first for everything.
Oh, sure. Oh, I love it when you're here. Yeah. And also, you know. Well, we're done.
Have we hit our peak?
Oh, no.
Hey, I just keep asking for it.
Yes, you do. Do you want an awkward pause or a mouth organ or a cash prize?
Oh, cash prize.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, I haven't done that.
Surprise me. Who would have thought a beautiful actress would want a big cash prize? Time is it? Shadow Steve!
For the big cash prize!
50 American dollars. I've done this for a while.
No, I haven't done this for a while, so you have to remind me because I've done all the others.
All right, 50 Americans. It's easy. There's two ways to win. You can either answer a question or you can guess what's in my box. Here's how that works. I imagine a box in my head. I don't know what's in it. Only Jeff knows what's in it. So you try and guess what's in it, and then if you're right, Jeff will tell us, and if you're wrong, you have to take all your clothes off.
Thank God I have my coconut.
Yeah. Coconuts count as clothes.
Okay, I don't want to answer a question because I'll definitely not be able to.
Well, I think you'd do
pretty good.
This
is when I get... this is what I'm afraid of. If I asked a question on the spot, maybe I should do it. Let me confront my fears. Okay. Here goes.
All right, you ready?
Not really, but let's try it.
Iceland is in the North Atlantic. Its capital city is Reykjavik. In a recent survey, what percentage of men said they wouldn't mind being stupid if they could have the perfect body? Was it C, 19%?
I think it's C.
Your name and what you do at the show. After three, one, two, three. These people here, we all work on the show together, and these people here are like family to me, which means I ignore them and they ask me for money. But we've been working together for, and you know you know what this is like? Is if CBS had been told to put together the cover for the Sgt. Pepper's album. Now they think that I've asked them to come out for one last little bit in the old studio, and I have. I want you everybody to take a good look, and we have digital technology. Many of you will be able to freeze frame and find your favorite personality who works on the show and look at them. But more importantly, it's the deal I made with the IRS. All these people are about to get audited. All right, I'm going to stay quiet, and you tell me which ones are looking at my ass. All of them. We'll see you when we come back, everybody. Good night.